Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to create a Kafka message producer or event producer, log producer or stream producer, whatever you will call it. We will create a producer with Spring Boot that will send some text messages to a topic. First of all, our Spring Boot application will actually create the topic in our Kafka application. On our Kafka server, our Kafka server will be started up along with Zookeeper with Docker Compose, so we will have a Docker Compose.yml file. And I just left this drawing from this is from the last video I made about Kafka, we are only dealing with one Kafka broker in this example right here. We want to code something against something as simple as possible. So I'm going to create one Kafka broker. That means one Kafka server. I'm going to create one partition on this server, and I'm going to create one topic inside this Kafka broker right here, and I'm going to name it Mike, and the partition is just going to be partition one. And then what we're going to play with tonight and to focus on is this producer right here. How do we do this with Spring Boot? I'm not going to create the consumer tonight. That will be another evening. So when we can see we don't get any errors after we send some messages to our Kafka topic, then we just need to trust me that it works, maybe tomorrow or another day, then I'll create another video with the consumer, and then we can actually see that the messages are also consumed. But let us take it bit by bit. So I will just start up. I have created an application right here. I'll just show you how I did that. I press File, New Project, like that, and then I chose Spring Initialize. I'm using the Java SDK 11. I press Next. I gave it a good name. I chose Gradle. And I press Next again. Oh, I chose Java version 11 right here, and I press Next. I ticked off Lombok. I chose Web right here, Spring Web. I ticked off that, and then I went to and looked for Kafka. And you need to be a bit careful here. There's something called Kafka Streams, and there's something just called Kafka, and one of them is to play with the Kafka API directly, and the other one is to use the Spring library. And we want to use the Spring library. And then I press next finish. But you don't need those two right here. You only need one of them, and that is the one without the streams in the end. And I'll just show you the dependency right here. You need this dependency right here. This is the dependency. They always look alike, and you can actually see I've out-commented. Actually, I ticked off both to begin with, and then I out-commented the Kafka Streams dependency right here because I don't want to play with the library directly. I want to use the one through Spring. So actually, to complete this exercise, you don't need to know that much about Kafka. You just need to know there's something called a Kafka broker, then that is just a server. You need to know that there's something called a Kafka topic. Inside the topic, there are partitions, and we will just deal with one partition right now. And the partition is just a logical separation of the messages inside the topic. I have cheated a little bit because I've created this Docker Compose file before I started. There are many different. You can create your own, of course. I just found this on Docker Hub, and I am setting up. I'm using a Zookeeper right here, so this is my Zookeeper, and then I have one Kafka server right here. Usually, if people want to play with clusters, then of course they need two Kafka servers right here, and then they need a little bit more of configuration. But this example here I will try to focus on the most simple example possible. And what is important here is actually those listeners mentioned down here. The listeners down here, those are important, and especially if you see here, then we have one listener that will use the name Kafka : 1992. This is used if other Docker containers wants to communicate with Kafka, then they should use Kafka 1992. And then I'm mapping out the port from 2.90.92 out to my own local hosts. And so if I want to use it from my own development environment, then I need to use this local host, and then I need to use this port right here. And then they have a logical name, these listeners right here, and the logical name is used in multiple environments settings here. Of course, you can read up on all this if you want to. It is all very interesting, but let us just jump right into it. You just write Docker Compose, go into the folder where in the script folder, and then you go to a terminal, and then you write Docker Compose up, and then you will start this all the containers here. Actually, I'm not sure that I did that. Actually, I forgot to do that, so I'll just do that. I'm going to change directory, but that's good. Then we can do this together. There's no problem in that. Docker Compose. I always like to write down first, because then if I made some changes or if I did some stuff, then I know that now they are gone. Now the containers are gone. Then I can write up again like this. And now it starts Zookeeper and it starts my Kafka. And now it's actually up and running. Now I'm pressing F12 again. I'm using Quake. If you're thinking about why I'm pressing F12 to get a terminal, that's because I use Quake for Linux Mint. Another thing, I just want to show the README file right here, because this is actually the agenda for tonight. First, we're going to create a new topic, and we need to do that, we need to create two beans, a Kafka admin bean and a new topic bean. And it's very, very simple to do that. After that, then we're going to create a producer. The producer needs a Kafka template, so we need to create a bean with that returns, so that's a method that returns a Kafka template. The Kafka template, it needs a producer factory where we configure how the Kafka producer factory should actually act, which server it should connect to, and the same with the admin up here. So let us just get right into it. I've created a config folder right here. So the first thing I would actually like to do is I would actually like to create a Kafka properties file where I have a bootstrap address property mapped from our application to properties. You can see here I've actually already created a property, mykafka.bootstrapaddress localhost, and I want to map that to a class. So let us just get started. First, Java class. This has nothing to do with Kafka. This is just plain Spring configuration, if you will. So I'm Spring properties, actually, Spring configuration properties. So let me name this my Kafka properties like this. And then I'm going to use Lombok. So I'm going to say that this is data. And I also need to say that this is configuration properties. And I need to say that I want to use my Kafka as the prefix, like this. And now my IntelliJ is complaining that I have not enabled configuration properties for my application yet. That is correct, but I have actually prepared it right here, my Kafka properties. So I'm just going to comment in this one, or this line right here, enable configuration properties, and then with this class right here. I'm also going to, so let us go back to our configuration right here. Now the complaining should stop. Thank you very much. And then we need that property from our file right here. That means that that is a bootstrap address. We want to map that to our class, to our configuration class. So I'll do that right here. I'll say private final string bootstrap. And then I need a capital A here. Then it will make the dash itself. And then I need some more Lombok, then I need to say... No, that's actually okay, and I don't need to make it final, actually. But I think we actually want to. So that is actually... Let us try to stop with that right now. And now let us try to create the topic. Now I want to create the topic, so let us create the Kafka topic creation or configuration. Okay. Configuration like this, annotate with configuration like this, and here we want to create a bean, and this should be the new topic. Actually, I want to create a new topic right here, new topic, and I want it to be public, so it's easier to test. Return new topic, like this. And then I need a name, a number of partitions, and a replication factor. The name, I'll just name it Mike right now. Yes, I know I should use a constant. I know that's a static private final somewhere. A number of partitions, 1, And the replication factor, one, we just want one copy of all the streams or messages to this topic right here. Then I need to, before actually I can do that, then I need this to create a Kafka admin, and that is also created with a bean. So I need to create that by doing this public Kafka admin like this, Kafka admin. And now it's a little bit more tricky because when I'm creating a new Kafka admin, then we need some configuration, Kafka admin. See here, right here, it takes a map. This is a configuration, so I need to give it some configuration right here. I need to create that right here, map, string, objects. And this is config equals new, has map like this. And then I need to add config.put. And now I need to add the something with Bootstrap. I forgot what actually the name, so I can actually look in the readme.md file. Let me just check right here. Admin client config, this is the one I want to add. I could actually just copy the whole line, but admin client config, that is a Kafka class, imported. Can see that it's actually up right here. Here it is. And my Kafka properties, I've not defined that yet, so I need to add, want to add some blombok now. I want to say required arch constructor, because then I will get this injected, private, final, my Kafka properties, and then I can name the Kafka properties just like it is in the method right there. Now it will be injected by Spring automatically. So this is the topic. This is a topic configuration. So now the topic should be created by itself. And I forgot a semicolon right there. Let us create the Kafka template configuration, because we actually need that. We need the Kafka template configuration. Kafka template configuration. That is quite important. That is where we can send that's where we can send messages. Configuration. And here we need a bean. We need it to return Kafka template template like this, yes. And I'll just name it Kafka template configuration. Then I'll return new Kafka template like this. And then I need a producer factory, and I'm going to create a method inside this class where we define this create method. Yes, thank you very much. Here it is, and return new producer factory. Okay, there's a default Kafka producer factory. This one, yeah, and it also takes some config, so I need to set that. Need to create that. So I need a map, and it's a string, an object is the value, and let us just import the class right away. And config equals new hash map. If only my fingers were not that choppy, then I could write it in the right case for the first time. But it's okay, we will get through it. Config that put, and then we need the key. But now we need the properties, and I have the properties in there. I have them down here. I'm going to copy paste this. So what we need to set the Bootstrap address once again, and then we need to set some serialize. So we need to say that we want to use the string serializer. So yeah, key value serializer, class config. So that, yeah, it's just we are using strings. That's actually what we are telling. Spring right here, or the default Kafka producer factory. That's what we're telling it. Kafka properties. Yeah, I forgot to. And we also want to inject the Kafka properties right here. So I'll say private final Kafka my Kafka properties like this, Kafka properties. So now I also have this. And now I can actually produce something, because now the important thing here is that we get the Kafka template right there. Usually also annotate this with bean actually. Let me only get one of them. And I'll remove this and write public. Then I want to create my producer. So this will be my Kafka producer service. And this is a service. And here we want to produce some messages. So that means that we actually need the Kafka template. So let us just add that. I'm using required args constructor like this. Then I can write private final and then Kafka template. Then it will be injected automatically. And then I'll have a public void produce message. So now I'm producing some messages when what this method here is it's called. Kafka template dot send message. And here there are different versions of this. The one we are going to use is just the topic and the data. There's actually something where we can use a key that is used. The key is used for if we want to make sure that messages arrive to the consumer in the right order. We cannot always be sure of that, because maybe sometimes because of if we have a cluster where we need a lot of where the messages need to be written and replicated throughout multiple servers, then we can actually not be sure that the messages, the streams, actually will come in the right order. So that's where that's where the key comes in. But in our simple world right now, we're not going to use a key. You can actually also use a partition and say we want it on this specific partition. But we're just going to say we just want to write to a topic and we want to write some data right here. So the message, let us just create a message right here. So we say string.format and then we'll say hello, this is a Kafka message. And then I want to add the date, local date time. And I would also like to have a number, some kind of ID. So we can see maybe I want that in the beginning actually, hello. I want that. Like this, percentage D, this is a number. And then we can have a private, then we can have a private static int, and then this is the running number. Yeah, running ID equals, and it's not running ID equals 0 to begin with. And then we write running ID plus plus. And then we want the date, that would be the local date time dot now dot, yeah, to string like this. I know we did not have to write to string, I'm doing it anyway. And this is the message, so let us set this to a new local variable. Yes, message. And I want this to happen every 10 seconds. So that means that I want to schedule. And then I can say fixed rate equals, and then 1000 because it's milliseconds. And then I want to say that it's every 10 seconds. Add an initial delay, maybe 5 seconds delay in the beginning, just so we don't send the message right away. That should actually be it. Oh, I forgot one thing actually. Under application, I want to enable scheduling or else my scheduler doesn't work. And another thing, I want to add some logging actually in my producer. Right here, SL4J. log.info, and I'll say produce message, produce message, begin. And I'm going to duplicate this line here, and then in the end, let me say end, and then we also write the message that we produced. And here we have the message right here. Let us try to start this code. We wrote a lot of code now, so let us see. Maybe I introduced some errors on the, or maybe I didn't. So let us just check for that now. Run the demo. So this is just the producer. We have not created any consumer. So I'm just looking. I just want to see that there are no errors actually. Required blah blah blah. Required being of type string that could not be found. Okay, my Kafka properties right there. My Kafka bootstrap address. Let me just check what happened there. Private final. Should also have required args on. Let me just check. Required as constructor. Also want the default, maybe constructor. Constructor. All args, no args constructor. Yeah, let us also just add that. And let us not make it final, just press like that. Bootstrap address. My Kafka. My Kafka dot bootstrap address. Did I misspell it? That looks okay. Let us just try again, see what happens. It's already defined in properties. Okay, it is already defined. Yeah, that's right. We don't need those two. Let's see what happens now. Let me just check my configuration actually. Looks fine. Looks fine. Let us start again. Sometimes I do that mistake because these configurations is just a map, it's not type safe. So sometimes I actually add the right key, but then I add maybe just Kafka properties without the string actually. Sometimes I give it the wrong type. Right now here we can actually see this is a huge success. We actually we are producing a message right here, begin, end, hello, one, and then you can see here that this is every 10th second, then we are sending this message to Kafka. So how do we know we're actually sending this to Kafka? We do not have a consumer yet. No, I know that. Oh, let me just move myself up right here. I know that it's difficult to actually verify when we don't have a consumer. But one thing I could do, I could actually stop the Kafka. I could actually stop the server, and then we can actually see that we get some errors down here. So let me just try that. Now I'm stopping it. And let us just see what we actually get right here now. Now you can see it here, the connection actually is not there anymore, could not be established, broker may be unavailable. So this is good for, enough for me for now, because I want to focus on the producer right now. There's a lot with this Kafka here, and then I'll create the consumer example. I'll create a consumer project that will work together with this producer example right here, and I'll do that very soon. But thank you very much for watching, and have a great evening, and I hope to see you again very soon. Bye-bye.